गुड इवनिंग मैम।
गुड इवनिंग ऑल ऑफ यू। बस
गुड इवनिंग मैम।
गुड इवनिंग। यस प्लीज एंटर। यस
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yes, good afternoon, all of you. Children, so we, in the previous period, we were dealing with what are circles, isn't it? And circumference of a circle, right? Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
What do you mean by circumference of a circle? We have studied, no?
Area around the circle.
Length of the boundary.
Yes, length of the boundary, isn't it? Length of the boundary is called the perimeter. And actually the perimeter of the circle is known as the circumference of the circle. Okay, so just see, the circumference of a circle means the distance, around the circle is known as the circumference of the circle. And I showed you how, by using a wire, I have shown you how we can find the circumference, isn't it? Suppose,
yes,
this length, you see, using this length, I am forming a circle. Okay, I formed a circle using the wire. And what is circumference? When I cut it in the middle and I stretch it, I got the circumference of the circle, isn't it? The length of the wire is the circumference of the circle. Now, hope you got the idea what is circumference. Clear? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
This period, we are going to see the relation between circumference and diameter of a circle. Okay. So, let us see. We'll see the relationship between circumference and the
diameter.
Relationship between circumference and diameter. Okay. So there is an experiment. Actually, there are experiment I have to make you do it, but now it is not possible. What you have to do is like this. Just draw a circle in a paper. You are drawing a circle in a paper. Okay, we'll put the center also. And the radius can be 3.5. Okay, first one, 3.5 centimeter radius. First circle, just 3.5 centimeter
radius. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yes, good afternoon. Second circle, we will draw around. Next circle, it is 7 centimeter radius. Okay, let it be 7 centimeter radius, another circle. And again, another circle is drawn of around radius 10.5 centimeter. 10.5 centimeter. And one more circle of 21. One more circle of 21.0 centimeter. Okay. So, four circles we have drawn. Four circles are drawn. And what can be the radius of the first one? Can you tell me what is the radius? This is radius is 3.5. Isn't it? So, what will be the diameter?
3.5 into 2.
3.5 into 2. Here, diameter will be what? 10.21.
21
centimeter, double it, isn't it? So, what is diameter? 2 times R, that is 2 times radius is the diameter. So, here diameter will be
14.
14.
Here diameter will be
42
centimeters, isn't it? Double
42.
It.
42.
So, radius,
ma'am, double R. Yes, I'll send you the letter in.
So, this the diameter is double that of the radius. Okay. Now the teacher can ask the. Now what you have to do is you have to find the circumference of the circle. Each circumference of each circle. How can you do it? See here. What you have to do is.
No.
Don't go further. We are going to find out the formula. Okay. How we got this 2 pi r? 2 pi r is a circumference, I know. But how we got that 2 pi r? That's what I am going to explain. Okay. So what you have to do is keep a thread over here. Okay. Thread, just make a circle with the thread over the circle drawn. Bring it here. Then stretch it on a scale. Okay. Take that thread out and stretch it on a scale. You will get the circumference. Isn't it? Again, same way, keep the thread here, again stretch it over the second circle, bring it here, take it out, again stretch it on the scale, just keep it on the scale, find out the circumference. Like that. Good afternoon. Like that, all the circles, you have to find out the circumference also. Okay, so what all things you found? First, you have drawn a circle with such and such radius, different radius, isn't it? So first draw a circle with different radius, find its diameter, then find out its circumference. Okay, now we will put all the measures in a table. We are going to put all the measures under a table. In a table, okay, not under a table, in a table. Under a table means under the round table. Okay, so we will make a table of whatever we have done. First one, radius, then diameter, then circumference. Radius, diameter, circumference. So first one was, it is 3.5 centimeters. So 7 centimeter was the radius. Circumference, suppose when you see, circumference will be 22 centimeter. Okay, 22 centimeter. When you do like this, you will get 22 centimeters as circumference. Then next one, 7 centimeter. 7 centimeter radius, 14 centimeter will be the diameter.
We got the 22.
Then when you measure with this wire, you will get the length as 22 if the radius is 3.5. Just check it. Okay. That is an experiment. And next one, for 714. Then you see the circumference will be 44. Then next one is the radius is 21. Then diameter, you know, into 2. So it is 42. Then measure its circumference. You will get the circumference as 130, sorry, you will get, it was 7, 21 is the radius, diameter 42, and it will be 132 centimeters as circumference. Okay.
Somehow we will get the circumference.
Yes.
See, I told you, just keep, if this is the circle which you are drawing, suppose the radius is 3.5, okay, 3.5 centimeter. Diameter, you know it is 7. Just keep a thread over it. Take a thread, keep a thread on it, and just stretch the thread on this circle. Take it out, keep it on a scale, and measure the length. It will be 22 centimeters. Understood? That is an experiment which you do. Okay, and the results are like this. Now, I'll tell you the what is it, then you will understand how you will get it. 1 minute. Because these are all measurements which are accurate. Look, now just simply calculate what is C by D. Circumference of the circle divided by the diameter. What is the value you get? First one, it is 22 by 7 diameter. 22 by 7, that you will get 3.14. The number is this. You will get a bigger number. Okay. 3.14. It goes on like that. 3.14 something something something. You do so many numbers. It will extend. It never stops. In higher class, you will study some transcendental numbers and all. While taking square root, I have told you what are the rational numbers. While taking rational numbers, I told you what are rational number and irrational number, etc. This is one of the irrational number. Okay, the decimals never stop nor repeat. So such numbers are known as irrational numbers. Okay, no. So but we approximately take the value as 3.14. Okay, next again, this one is 44 by 14. Check, you will get again the same value, approximately this one. Again, you find the ratio 132 by 42. Again, you will get the same value, 3.14. Okay, so like that, when you do the experiment, you can see that the value of circumference divided by the diameter will be always approximately this number, 3 point something. Okay, 3.13, and that number we represent by a letter called pi. We represent by a letter called pi. Its value can be taken either as 22 by 7 or 3.14. We take only 3.14.
Ma'am, these three every numbers are same. Ma'am, in this three answer, every numbers are same.
Five.
What? I didn't understand.
Ma'am, in this answer, every numbers are same.
That's what I was speaking about.
I didn't because
ma'am, when we check in calculator also, every numbers are same.
Every numbers are same. So 3.14, 22 by 7, 44 by 4, whatever. You take any radius and check the circumference and divide the circumference by its by its diameter. Any circle you take with any measurement, you will find that the circumference divided by the diameter of that circle is a constant. Okay. Constant number, 3.14. Or around 3.14. Clear? That's why this is taken as a constant. Okay, 3.14, that number, or 22 by 7 is taken as a constant, and we represent it by a letter called pi. Okay, we represent it by a letter called pi.
Ma'am, in the textbook, it is pi.
Pi.
Pi. It is only pi.
Pi. Okay, it is pronunciation. This. Okay.
Pi.
So, now,
ma'am, I don't understand that. C.
C is circumference. C.
How
is
to find that?
Which one? Circumference. That's what I told you. Here you see, I told you to just look. This is a circle. Just place a thread over it. Just place a thread over it. And just make a circle over the circle drawn with that thread. Just take it out, stretch it over a scale and measure. Take the measurement. Okay, you will get one measurement that is known as the circumference of the circle. Did you understand what is meant by circumference?
Yes,
what is the meaning of circumference? It is the length of the circle.
So how will we understand that that circle has that radius and diameter?
You are drawing the circle, no? You have to draw the circle with a particular radius. Without radius, how can you draw a circle? You are drawing a circle with a particular radius, isn't it?
Yes.
You are drawing a circle with particular radius. So radius you know.
Ma'am, but in this you given, right? Some radius and diameters.
That is example. That is only example. Okay. You can take any measurement, any radius, and draw whatever radius you take, whatever be the radius of the circle, this thing remains the same. That is circumference of the circle and its diameter ratio of circumference to diameter remains the same. What is it? It is 3.14. Okay, and this value, this ratio is represented by the letter pi.
Ma'am, if we take any radius, we'll get this itself?
Yes, 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 yes. Okay, any radius, circle with any radius, check its circumference and divide it by its diameter. Answer will be this. That's why it is taken as a constant number, 22 by 7 or 3.14. That is what we call as pi. Okay, pi. It's an alphabet. Okay, so now when I describe, you will understand. Okay, this one, when I explain, you will understand why I explained the meaning of pi. Okay, so this was to explain the value of pi or meaning of pi. Clear? Now let us see why I explained pi. Now you understood that C by D is a constant, that is pi. C by D is pi. You know C by D is pi. Clear? C by D, that constant is known as pi. Or yes, we represent it by the letter pi. So what is C? Circumference. How to find circumference? See, you were asking how to find circumference of a circle, isn't it? We are going to develop a formula for finding circumference of a circle. Okay. So what is circumference of a circle? D will be taken to this side, isn't it? So pi D. Pi into D.
D.
That you understood how? D is taken to the right side.
Transpose.
It becomes the numerator. Okay. So pi D. Now C is equal to pi. Again, what is D?
What is 2 D? Radius.
2 into radius. 2 into radius. So we can put it in the form 2 pi. Number 5 first. Pi R. This is the formula for finding circumference of a circle. So, understood? C.
Yes, ma'am.
We don't have a formula to find out what is circumference of a circle. Till now, we were measuring with the use of thread. Isn't it?
Yes.
So, now we have developed the formula for finding the circumference of a circle. What is it? 2 into pi into radius of the circle. So, 2 into pi means you can take 22 by 7. You can take any both values, any value you can take. Either you can take 22 by 7 or you can take 3.14.
What that R indicates?
Huh?
What that R indicates?
R is radius. Radius of the circle. Radius of the circle. So 2 into 22 by 7 into radius of the circle give you circumference of the circle. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So, what is the value of circumference? What is the circumference of a circle? It is
2 pi r.
2 pi r. So, circumference of a circle is equal to 2 pi r. Don't forget this formula. Circumference of a circle is 2 pi r. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
This is not recording.
Yes, ma'am, it is.
It's recording. Now, is it clear 2 pi r is the circumference of the circle? Now, let us see some problems related to it. Just to see this exercise 11.3. Exercise 11.3. Find the circumference. Find the circumference circumference of the circles with the following radius. Take pi 22/7 value. Okay. So what is this first one? Radius given 14 centimeter. Radius is 14 centimeter. So what will be the circumference? C is equal to 2 pi r, isn't it? So what is it? It is equal to 2 into pi value is given 22/7. 22/7 into what is given here? It is radius of the circle given 14. So into 14. 7 2s are 14. So what is the answer? C is equal to how much? 2 into 4. 4 into 22. Answer is
88
centimeter. Square don't write because it is circumference. Circumference means it is perimeter, isn't it? So no need of square there. Only for area, we use the unit centimeter square, meter square, etc. So 88 centimeter circumference. So find out the other ones like that. Other two, what is the answer for the other two questions?
Ma'am, mm means?
No, millimeter.
Millimeter.
Ma'am,
you have to do the same, method, same. Right?
Yes. Don't worry about the units. It is same unit you have to write, that's all. So, millimeter.
Ma'am, 176 millimeter.
Yes. Second one is 176 millimeter. Very good. Third one.
Ma'am, 132 centimeters.
Isn't it? So, this is how you calculate the circumference of the circle. Is it clear, children?
No, ma'am, I don't understand.
Who didn't understand?
None.
Can anybody explain to her now? Nobody understood? See, which one? Anan, tell me which one you didn't understand.
Whether I didn't understand both questions.
Both questions means first one.
Ma'am, how much questions we discussed? Two questions we discussed, right?
Three.
Only this.
A and B.
A, B, C.
That three I didn't understand.
14 is the radius given. Okay. Did you understand the formula? Circumference is equal to 2 pi r.
2 pi r.
Okay. That you understood. Now listen. First one is 14. Second one is 28.
So always pi will be given, right?
Pi will be given. Pi, no need to give. You should understand. It is 22/7 or 3.14. You have to study it by heart. No change for that value. It's 22/7 always. Okay. See this. Listen. So first one, it was given, find the circumference of the circle whose radius is 14 centimeter. Okay. So C is equal to how much? We have studied the formula 2 pi r. Anand, did you understand this one?
Ma'am, I was asking whether you were discussing the first question.
You understood first question?
Yes, ma'am, you were discussing that ABC
ABC, yes.
Okay.
That did you understand?
Okay, yes, ma'am.
Anyway, I will do this. 2 into 22/7 into radius is what given? Radius is given in the question.
14.
So with the 7, 2s are 14. Okay. So then what is the, just multiply 2 into 22, 44. 44 into 2, 88. 88 centimeter is the answer. Second one, C is equal to again 2 pi r, 2 into 22/7 into 28. 7, 4 times in 28, right?
Yes.
Then multiply. What is the answer?
44. 8 into 22.
2 2s are 44 into 4. 176 millimeters. Like that, you have to calculate. Is it clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Who is that?
Yes.
Amal.
Amal?
Yes.
Okay. So next, we'll start with what is the time? 4:47. Okay. Is there time to start with area? Yes. Next topic is area of a circuit. Roughly, I'll explain in detail. I should take time and explain. Otherwise, we'll be confused totally. Again, we are not going to study the formula for area. We are going to derive the formula for area of a circuit. Okay, we are going to derive the area of the circuit. Suppose we are drawing a circle like this. Circle is drawn. I am cutting it now two pieces, fold it like this. So many pieces you make, okay? When you cut so into different pieces and then cut it into small pieces. And when you arrange, you will be getting a figure like this. You may get a figure like this. This little yes. Difficult to draw. Not that easy. Okay. So it will be like this. Some figure you will get like this. It is not that easy to draw. Okay. Something like this. When you arrange, we have to do the here ending. Okay. Now, when you close it, just see, you will get a figure. You will get a figure like this. When you cut it too much short, okay, when you cut it more, so many pieces and then arrange, it will look like a parallelogram. This side and all will be this circle. Each thing can be very, very small. Okay. When you arrange, it will look like a line only. Okay, this curved ones will look like a line. So you will get it like a parallelogram, get the shape of a parallelogram. Then if you cut the circle into different pieces along the radius, if you cut the circle along the radius and arrange upside down like this, what you will get? You will get a parallelogram shape. You have inserted all parts of the circle in that, okay? And you just see what is the this one represent? What does this thing? Yellow again, green. What does these things represent? These are all radius of the circle. Okay, this and this is the radius of the circle, right? This one, yes. This part is coming over there. This part is coming over the side. And what are these parts are coming over here? Half will come here. Okay, half of the circle arc will come here, half part, other half is coming over this side. Okay, so it resembles a parallelogram. What is the area of a parallelogram?
B into H.
B into H.
Base into height is the area of a parallelogram. Okay, base into height. So this is the base of this parallelogram, and this can be taken as the height of the parallelogram. Or rectangle or parallelogram, whatever height of the parallelogram. Now this is the base of the parallelogram. Can you say anything about this base? What is this actually?
Parallelogram.
That parallel.
This thing
curves in the circle.
This one. It around half of this arc is here, arranged here. Isn't it? Half of the circle. Half of the circle is till here is arranged here. And remaining half part, that is this half part, is arranged on the top, right?
Yes.
So this much means what is it? It is half the perimeter of the circle, right?
Yes.
Half of C, half of circumference, isn't it? Base.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Did you understand? Now you have to ask. If you didn't understand, you have to ask now. I cannot start from the beginning. It is difficult. This much, is it clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this base means it is the half of the circumference of the circle. Okay. So half C. Half C means what? Half of? What is C?
Circumference.
Isn't it? C is yes. What?
2 pi r.
So half into 2 pi r. We are discussing about the base of this parallelogram. Okay. Base. Base is equal to half into 2 pi r. Now 2 and 2 cancelled. What is remaining? Pi r is remaining.
Pi r.
Pi r is remaining.
Yes.
So the base is pi r. Isn't it?
Yes.
Base
yes.
Is. Now this base is what? This base is pi r. Pi r. And what about this h? H is the radius of the circle, right? This one is the radius of the circle.
Yes.
So what is the area of this figure? I told you it is resembling a parallelogram. So base into height. What is the base? Pi r.
R into pi r.
Pi r. And pi r is the base into height. That is also r.
R.
So what is
the
pi r
into r?
Is pi r square. That is how area of the circle became pi r square. Actually, this is an activity which you have to do. You have to draw a circle, paste color paper on it, or cut a circle with color paper, draw small radius inside, cut it into small pieces, paste it like this diagram, like this on a cardboard, and you have to explain all this formula, derivation of area of a circle. That is an activity. Okay. So,
ma'am, could you repeat this in next class?
Which one?
This.
You just see the video once more. That is more better, no?
Yeah.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Just go. When you get the video of this, you just watch it once more.
And today it will come?
Today, no.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow it will come. Tomorrow. So any one more video if you want, I will show next video, next class.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, video related to this area of the
circle. On Monday, it will be.
On Tuesday. Next class is on Tuesday. I'll show another video of this. Okay. So
okay,
this
ma'am.
One, what is the problem with this? You didn't understand how we derived the area of the circle. Area of the circle. What is the area of the circle now? We were doing it with
pi
r square.
That is what you have to study. Okay. I explained all these things for you to understand how we are deriving the area of the circle. Okay. So what you have to study is this pi r square. Area of the circle is
pi r square. Then perimeter is there.
Sir, perimeter is the circumference of the circle.
Ma'am, attendance.
Okay.
2 pi r. Okay.
Okay. Now, ma'am, attendance.
What is the time now?
5 more minutes.
5 more minutes.
Okay, so
minutes.
What is two things we studied today? Circumference of the
area of the circle.
So, once more, if you want, I'll explain and I'll show the video in the next PD. Okay, thank you, children. So, I'll take at the next.
Can you show the slide one more time? Ma'am, remove your phone. Ma'am, can you show the slide one more time?
Which one?
Now view closed.
I don't know whether it will be there. Let me check. Yeah, it is there.
Ma'am, you didn't share it.
I didn't share. We go back. Now, can you see?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, shall I?
Yes, ma'am.
Stop.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I'll show another video regarding this. Okay, then it will be more clear to you. I think so, but it was confusing when I saw just explained with video in other class. They didn't understand. When I explained like this only, they understood. Okay. So let me take the attendance. Yes, Sriram is present.
Present, ma'am.
Yes. So today 3 periods were there. No, it was science. Okay.
5 periods.
5 periods for Indian, 4 periods for Malayalam.
Uh-huh. Aditya Nanu?
Absent. Because of that, the class is silent.
Eh? Class is?
Silent.
Okay. Abhinand Krishna? Present.
Present.
Abhinav Manoj is present. Who is absent? You have to tell me. Okay. Abhinav Bijoy is absent.
No, Abhinav Bijoy is present.
Present. Abhinav PA is absent.
Yes.
Ahmad Afin is absent. Albert Jojo is present.
No, absent. Amal is present.
Amal is present. Amna Shirin is present.
Anan is present.
Angelia.
Present, ma'am.
Present. Anthony Biju. Anthony Babu.
Present.
Present. Anusha Latish. Anusha.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Arjun MR.
Present. Present.
Present. Ayan.
Absent.
Okay. Benedict. Absent. Carlin is present. Carlin Matthew.
Present, ma'am. Present, ma'am.
Dilla Darshan.
Present, ma'am.
Emelina Rose. Present.
Absent.
Emelina Rose is absent. She was present in the morning. Ishal is present. Gauri Parvati is present. Gokul Krishna is present. Is he present?
No, Gokul is absent.
No.
Gokul is absent. Okay. Hesa is present.
Present.
Yes.
Ija Jeevaraj.
Yes.
Present, ma'am.
Johane. Present. Johane is present.
Absent.
Krishna Kripa, present.
Present.
Malavika, present. Yes.
Yes.
Milan,
present. Present, ma'am.
Miziad.
Absent.
Nelvin Kenu. Nelvin.
Absent.
Lakshmi is present.
Present, ma'am.
Parthi V.S.
Present.
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 Okay, Parvati is present. Prajida, present. Pranavatmak is present, no? Pranavatmak. Absent. Rudra is present. Rudra.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Shifana.
Absent.
Absent. Shreya. Present. Shreya is present.
Shreya is absent.
Absent. Srihari.
Shreya is present. Shreya is present.
Okay. Srihari V.S. Srihari.
Absent.
Absent.
Absent. Okay, Tanmay.
Present.
Present.
Uma Parvati. Absent.
Absent. Vaishnav,
present. Gauri
Shangari, present.
Okay, children, thank you. If you want, I'll explain once more in the next class. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.